Assalamu alaikum dear students, today we will discuss how to make a good body paragraph. Body paragraphs are very vital parts of the essay because you take the help of body paragraphs to support your main thesis of the essay, and you use all the arguments and evidences in your body paragraphs to prove your point. So what is the composition of a body paragraph and how you can make a good body paragraph? The first part is a body paragraph contains a topic statement, and a topic statement is a single statement that contains one idea and it addresses two questions. The first question is, what is this paragraph about? So a topic statement tells the examiner that what is this paragraph about. Secondly, it tells the examiner what you want to prove in paragraph. So make a topic statement by keeping in mind these two questions that you are gonna write topic statement and you have to prove it in your body paragraph. So after writing a topic statement, you have to prove your topic statement with the help of evidences and supportive arguments. So how you can bring variety and you can prove your topic statement? I am gonna share a formula with you people that you can use to prove your topic statements in your body paragraph, and the formula is REMNC. So this is a formula that you can use to prove your topic statements, and if you follow this formula, you can bring in the required variety that is required to get good marks in essay paper. The first point is reason. Yes, you can support your topic statement by providing the reason behind the phenomenon you are discussing in your topic statement. Then you can also give an example to prove your topic statement. Then you can also add a quotation to prove your topic statement. You can also add facts and figures, and you can also make comparative analysis. For example, if you are discussing about the cause of poverty, that poverty, if the topic statement is that poverty is due to the lack of education facilities in our country, so you will give the reason first that because of the lack of education facilities, there is low literacy rate in our country. Because of that, there is joblessness in the country, and due to joblessness, there is rapid poverty. So this is the reason for having poverty in our country. So you have proved your topic statement by giving the reason. Then you can also give an example that in the far-flung areas, education facilities are not according to the requirements. That's why there are many people who have got no skill to get a job. That's why the poverty is rampant in those areas. So by giving an example, you can prove your topic statement. After that, you can also add a quotation of some person, some well-known person, to support your topic statement. But the quotation must be relevant with your topic statement. The quotation must prove your topic statement that poverty is due to the lack of educational facilities. Then you can support your topic statement with the help of facts and figures. For example, if you have got some stats, you have got some numbers to prove that poverty is due to the lack of educational facilities, you can provide all the numbers in your body paragraph to prove your topic statement. Then you can make a comparative analysis between the two regions, two cities, or two countries, that in the far-flung areas we have got less education facilities. That is, so is the reason that poverty is more prevalent in far-flung areas. But in cities, as we have got better education facilities, so poverty is under control in the city. So you can make a comparative analysis between the two cities, two regions, or two countries in order to prove your topic statements. If you follow this formula and you give a reason, then examples, then quotation, then numbers and comparative analysis, your body paragraph will contain variety, and it will also keep the examiner intact, and it will also give the examiner something to join. And the last two lines of your body paragraph, that's called a concluding statement, and the purpose of the concluding statement is to keep the trust of reader intact. So in the last two lines, you can end on a positive note, and you can relate your body paragraph with the next coming body paragraph of the essay. So you can develop a coherence in your essay. So this is how you can make a good body paragraph, starting with the topic statement, that is a single statement containing one idea. And after that, you can use all these tools to prove your topic statements and to bring variety in your essay writing. So dear students, you can follow this technique to score good marks in essay paper. And if you follow this technique, you don't need to cram a lot of material, because you can write these things quite easily. So thank you so much for watching, and do subscribe, because I am gonna share more techniques to score good marks in essay paper. Thank you so much.